My diva, you're safe.
Hosea, it's been a while.
I wasn't sure what was going to happen when the singing ministry was attacked, but now...
I was worried too, and yet I found the child of Eesa. Clearly, Eesa's will is with us.
So, this must be the child of Eesa.
Yes, his name is Lark.
Wonderful. With him, we can fight against the evil god Real and save this world from destruction.
Destruction? Are you talking about Real's law? I don't really get it, but isn't all this stuff just religious junk?
Most certainly not. Our gods hold the fate of this world in their hands. If Real's law is taken up by Eesa, this world will be destroyed, just as the law states.
What do you mean?
You know the story of Genesis, right? That is no mere legend. Long ago, people fought for Re, creating the poisonous Hozon that destroyed the land. Eesa, who grieved over this, created the framework for a new world. That is the story of Genesis.
And you're saying that's all historical fact?
That's right. To cleanse the world, Eesa also created two other gods.
Imaginal and Real, right?
Yes. Imaginal represents creation and prosperity, while Real represents destruction and decay. They both create their own ideology for the future and give that to Eesa as the law. Eesa then chooses the better of the two laws and makes a revelation. Noirism's purpose is to spread that revelation to the world and guide humanity towards it.
But wasn't Noirism on the verge of extinction as a religion? I mean, I got the idea you guys were practically non-existent as an organization.
That is because Eesa has fallen into slumber, and along with that, the revelations have ceased. As such, Noirism has lost its reason for existence, and the people have forgotten to thank the gods.
Why did Eesa fall asleep?
That we do not know. However, before Eesa fell asleep, he sent an agent to this world. When this agent chooses a law and reaches the holy land of Noir, Eesa will be awakened.
So I basically exist for the sole purpose of waking Eesa?
Yes, and to decide the fate of this world. The gods created North Noirism and Olkinaism and were searching for the child of Eesa. For you. Lark, please help us.
I don't know. This is all so sudden.
We thought there was only one child of Eesa, but that is not the case at all. Real has lied. He claimed his law was not one of death in order to attract the second child to him. If Real's law is presented to Eesa, this world will be destroyed by the evil of crystallization.
Give me a break. You really think I'd go along with this stupid fairy tale? Do you have any actual proof of this?
Lark.
Listen, child of Eesa. If you think that, then this world is doomed to destruction. Alf, the other child of Eesa, has chosen Real's law and is already heading towards the Holy Land.
Hosea, please, give Lark some time. Anyone would be confused after hearing all of this at once. I didn't know enough to tell him before we came here.
Very well, child of Eesa. If you decide to help us, come and visit this cathedral again. But remember, the more time passes, the closer the world leans towards destruction.
Mr. Lark, it took you long enough.
What's wrong? You don't seem in a very good mood.
Let's just go to the inn for now, okay, Lark?
Okay.